The iPod is so fun and easy to use. You just take this cool little device, you plug it in over FireWire to your Mac, it launches iTunes, takes all your music, all your playlists, and automatically transfers it down onto your iPod, and then you can unplug and just go. It's so fast, you can now transfer a whole CD in 5 to 10 seconds, and all your music in just 5 to 10 minutes.
The iPod was designed for you to have your music to go. It's small, fits in your pocket, only 6.5 ounces, has over 10 hours of continuous battery life, and a super thin 5-gig hard drive. So not only can you take your music with you, but you can take your data with you wherever you go. The iPod is the first music device with FireWire, which is 30 times faster than USB, and has power. So when you plug in your iPod, you both download your tunes and charge your battery.
The iPod and your Mac work together as a complete solution. We make sure the hardware and the software all work together seamlessly. And that's one of the really cool things Apple can do.
I've had 3 MP3 players, and I haven't figured out how to use any of them. And this one, I held it, and 45 seconds later, I knew how to use it. I'm having a hard time getting my head around the fact that you could transfer an album onto this in 10 seconds. If I was 16 years old, I think I'd be able to deal with that a lot better. The design is really cool, I have to say. I don't know who your product designers are, but boy, you're not paying them enough.
The big design story is clearly the interface, and I think the simplicity of the buttons and of the jog wheel completely belie how powerful, how effective the interface truly is. It's really, really straightforward. You can choose a song, an artist, or one of your own playlists.
It's a beautiful thing.
That's it. It's so simple. If you hold the menu button down for a couple of seconds, that puts the backlight on. You've even got a choice of languages. It's completely intuitive. We're surrounded by loads of small products that are, I think, really difficult to use. I think our goal with the design of iPod was to design something that was small, but was also really easy to use.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed.
It doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure this thing out. And I ain't no rocket scientist, let me tell you. This thing's incredible. And the nice thing is, it's super simple. It's got 5 buttons and a scroll pad. And the scroll pad's so smooth, it's flawless. You know, you're not going to skip over something that you're looking for. You've got your own record store in this damn thing. This kicks every other product's ass right here.
Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
Do you remember what it was like when you got your first Walkman? You remember that feeling? When you got a first Walkman in your hand, it was like, wow. Well, I haven't picked up any MP3 player that has made me go, wow, okay, I want to carry this wherever I go. This is the first thing that makes me feel, wow, okay. It's hard to say what the coolest aspects of it are. They're all cool. Obviously, the look of it. You know, everyone's going to want to have one of these.
Our goal was to design the very, very best MP3 player we could, to design something that could become an icon. And you know, we'll see whether that's the case or not, but certainly as a design team, I can't remember the last time where we were collectively lusting after a product as badly as we are after an iPod.
I might have to steal your prototype.
I'll take 2 of them. One for my girlfriend and one for me, because I'm not sharing this with nobody.
You can see the thought and the time and the love that's gone into it. It's just wonderful. I want it now.
Baby, I'd just love to take a moment to give a round of applause to Ruby and Cena and their teams, in particular Tony and Jeff, Johnny and his team, who's made this product possible. They've been really working hard. We started this program at the beginning of this year, and it's been a very fast-track program. So thank you guys for working so hard. Now, we're going to be doing some marketing around this product. We've got a magazine insert which is going to be running. This is one of the spreads from it. 1,000 songs in your Mac, 1,000 songs in your pocket. Talks about iTunes, talks about AutoSync, talks about, obviously, iPod. And this insert's going to hit in November. We're going to be dropping 22 million copies in all the popular magazines. And we think this is going to be pretty cool. Also, this is a whole new category, of course, and no one's really educated the customers about this category. Nobody's made that investment. We're going to begin to make that investment with our inserts, and we also have a television ad that I'd love to run right now for you. So can we run that?